Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Now, today is a slow day on the news front. It's not like last season where we had Neil Lennon every day making a tit of himself. You know, Ange is conducting himself with a lot of professionalism, some class. You know, everything's kind of under wraps. So it's kind of a reach to try and find videos nowadays. But there's something I want to sit down and actually talk about today, and it's very rare of me to do it. I'm going to sit down and do an Anthony Ralston defence video because the Scotland lineup, or the Scotland squad, sorry, was released this morning. Once again, Anthony Ralston snubbed a position in the squad. Is Steve Clark right or wrong to do so? Well, let's sit down and talk about that today. Yeah, as I said, very rare of me to sit down and dedicate a video to none other than Anthony Ralston. Anthony Ralston's a player who this season has had a resurgence like no other. And we'll get on to talking about him himself and the season he's having, because that's everything that I need to back up my points in this video. But he's a guy who I have been so harsh on in the past, and I can't be harsh on him now. I can't be harsh on him in recent times, because he's been standing out like one of the best players in the squad for Celtic. That's just the reality of it. You know, it's not an exaggeration. It's not Celtic fans lying. It's not Celtic fans trying to make out someone's better than they are. He genuinely has been one of the best players in the squad throughout the entirety of the opening to this season. There's been a couple of games where he hasn't looked good enough, I will be honest in saying that, but for the vast majority, he's been a standout player for Celtic, and he's been more than deserving of a call-up to the Scotland squad this international break. But Steve Clark has decided, nope, he's not coming. We're leaving him behind, and I'm taking Nathan Patterson and Stephen O'Donnell ahead of him in the right-back position, which is something I feel like we have to talk about today. Before we go any further with the video, please make sure to hit the like button and also smash the subscribe button as well if you haven't already for more somewhat daily free content. But the like button is even more important. That helps people get the content on a more regular basis in that recommended section. So please smash that if you haven't. And let's talk about Big Tony Boy, the Holy Bricky. I can be first to admit that Celtic fans are somewhat guilty of maybe over-exaggerating the quality of players. I've been guilty of it. A lot of Celtic fans have been guilty of it in the past. And I think a lot of people have maybe been guilty with it to an extent with this particular player, Anthony Ralston. I think that he's someone that, because he's playing well, we've suddenly raised him on a pedestal that makes him look like the best right back in the league. And there's now no looking back for him. I'll admit that that's the case. But sometimes you've got to sit down and be honest and saying, this guy's one of the most informed players in the league at the moment. He's probably been the best right back in the league this season. Now, I already know there's Rangers fans watching this video, and I know there's Rangers fans that are going to be jumping down my throat for saying that Anthony Ralston is better than James Tavernier and Nathan Patterson. That is not what I'm saying. I'm not saying that. I'm saying this season on forum, there is no argument that right now Anthony Ralston has been a better player than James Tavernier and Nathan Patterson. Of course those two guys are better players than Ralston in terms of the bigger picture. They've had a kind of better couple of years than Ralston. They have been Patterson's been an international for the Euros for a reason, because he's a really good player. Tavernier has been, you know, up there for some of the top scoring, top assisting stats in the league for the past few years because he's a great player. I'm not for a moment coming out and saying that he's a better player than those two, but right now on current form, he's the best right back in the league, and he has been undeservingly snubbed from this Scotland setup. I've seen a lot of opposition fans saying, oh, you know, Celtic fans are going on and on about Ralston as if he's Dani Alves, or, you know, he's the next Cafu or whatnot. I don't think that that's the point we're making. I think it's just at the point now where we feel bad for the guy because he's been performing so well, he deserves this. I thought in the last international break that Ralston could have been called up, but I wasn't surprised that he wasn't. I knew that he just wasn't going to get the call-up from Steve Clark, but this time, I genuinely had hope for him. I genuinely thought, you know what, Anthony Ralston could make this call-up and could make this squad for this set of games. But he hasn't, and I just don't understand why. Now, I know Steve Clark is very... We know what Steve Clark's like now. He's done a tremendous job with Scotland. Fair play to him, and if he wants to go his way, then his way has already shown it works, it succeeds. You know, we're on track to maybe qualifying for the World Cup for the first time since 1998. We qualified for the Euros. I don't need to read out the stats. We know things are working. But you look at Stephen O'Donnell and Nathan Patterson right now, this season, and there is no justification as to why Tony Ralston is being left behind. And do you know what? I would normally say, okay, Steve Clarke's stubborn. He likes to pick the same squad. He likes to keep it relatively similar. But he's brought up Jacob Brown from Stoke City for the first call-up. So why is he not brought up Tony Ralston? Now, you cannot tell me that right now. I'm taking Patterson aside for a minute because Patterson is genuinely a player who's at an age that he's going to develop and needs these sort of chances in the Scotland setup. He's already shown he's decent enough in the Scotland setup, and he is a decent player. I'm not going to say he's not, but Stephen O'Donnell, on the other hand, Stephen O'Donnell, who's not had a great season, was foolishly sent off at the weekend. I just don't see any justification as to why Steve Clarke. I know he loves O'Donnell, and he was just never going to drop O'Donnell for him, but that, for me, is tiresome, and that is so annoying. Because Ralston has worked so hard and he's been so much better than both of these guys, and he's the one that's getting left behind just because he's not favoured by Clarke. This is bread and butter when it comes to international football. Managers have their favourites, they'll always pick their favourites, and I'm not going to sit here and cry about it all week. Look, listen, O'Donnell will end up going out and having a cracker of a game and against Moldova or whatnot, and I'll be shut up, but I just feel like that it's been unfairly done this time, and Ralston is more than deserving. For reference, Nathan Patterson has played 94 minutes of league football this season. Now, once again, Rangers fans ready to jump down my neck in the comments. You cannot say to me that I'm not saying he's a bad player. That is not what I'm saying. But you cannot tell me there is genuinely no reasoning as to why he deserves this spot more than Tony Ralston. If it was up to me, I'd be taking Patterson and Ralston. That's the two that I would be taking. But 94 minutes versus one of the most in-form players in the league at the moment. Baffling. If you just want to compare that to Tony Ralston for a moment, in the Premiership, 10 goals. Sorry, 10 goals. I wish it was 10 goals. 10 games, 3 goals, 2 assists. In the Europa League, 3 appearances. The Europa League, a standard above the Scottish Premiership. The Europa League with a goal in that as well. Europa League qualifying, he played 4 times in that. This is a guy that's made 21 appearances, 4 goals, 2 assists this season, which is far superior to Nathan Patterson and Stephen O'Donnell. And I do not care how many times we hear this argument about Clarke picking who he wants and who he's trusting and how they could be bit. We need to start picking players who are on form. It's a joke that Nisbet's in the squad, for example, over the likes of Tony Watt. I love Nisbet. I think he's a cracking player. But over Tony Watt at this moment in time, it makes no sense, and it's something that's held back this country for so long. Steve Clarke should be learning from that, and the likes of Ralston should be in. And he offers a versatility to this Scotland squad as well. Ralston this season, and this is maybe one of the arguments I get for not picking Ralston. Ange's system, Steve Clarke's system, very different. It might not work for Tony Ralston, and I completely understand that. I believe that Ralston can come into this system because we need that kind of width in our back line. We don't play with wingers. Ralston has shown this season he can move up the park, he can do work in the midfield, he can get narrow, he can stay wide. He's done it all this season under Ange Postecoglou. Now, if you're telling me that that doesn't work for Steve Clarke as well, I just don't buy it. I know that it's two completely different systems, but Gerrard's system's different. Graham Alexander's system is different, and you're telling me Jurgen Klopp's system is the same as Steve Clarke's? No, but Robbo thrives in this Scotland team, so how can Anthony Ralston not? Now, that's not me comparing those two for a moment, right? Don't get carried away, but what I'm saying is, I don't think that the system these guys are playing at in their clubs necessarily matters, because they're coming in and they're doing a job, and I think Ralston deserves a chance to do that job, but he's been snubbed yet again, and what can you do? Maybe Clarke is just guarding himself from being naive, you could say, by picking someone who's only came into form, really, at this point of his career. But I think you've got to install faith in these guys. This is someone who's a Celtic Academy graduate. He's played at the unders levels for Scotland. You know, he's not someone who's going to come in and not be good enough. He's been proving it at the highest level now for Celtic over this past few months. And I've been so critical of him. This isn't me rushing to the defence for the sake of Celtic. You know, this isn't me being that stereotypical Celtic fan. I'm trying my best not to be that. I'm saying this from a point of view that this is a guy who genuinely deserves his chance over the other guys in the squad. At this moment in time, there is no debate around it. If you're going off form, this guy's the right back of the league at the moment. That's a fact. That might change in 3 months' time. I'm not saying that that's going to be the case forever and ever now. I'm not saying that Ralston's the best right back in the league and always will be the best right back in the league. What I'm saying is right now at this moment in time, there is no one better and he should be in that squad because that's why international teams should be picked. That's how they should be picked. But of course, he's gone with his choices and we can't change it now. Callum McGregor and David Turnbull again, of course, called up to the Scotland squad. Let's hope they travel, have some good minutes, good football and come back fit and firing. We don't want to see anyone getting injured. I imagine it'll be this very similar to the last time where we see, you know, Turnbull barely play. We see McGregor play the majority of it. That's the way it goes normally. But they're guys who we need back safe and we need back fit. So hopefully that's the end goal from these two games against Moldova and Denmark. We wait to see the rest of the international squads to see who'll be going abroad and who'll be away. I imagine it'll be the normal crowd of players at Celtic. But yeah, I'm disappointed Ralston's not been picked. I must admit, really disappointed. But what can you do? Make sure to hit like and subscribe and I'll see you all next time.